what Shakia bhai has told me was that I should tell this guy to call him to validate the whole conversation, but he couldn't because he did not have network. That's sort of a very normal thing at or around that part of the world. So it's the kind of terrain you don't get a lot of network there, and that too a prepaid connection. So I sort of had some food there. The campsite was amazing, as you guys will be able to see. The campsite was fucking amazing. It was right in front of Hotel Ibex. I chilled out. It was quite sunny that day, and along with that there was a lot of wind, and I had some food, ginger lemon tea. Oh my fucking god, I wanted to show you guys something. So guys, this is a quite good spot. I love the graffiti here. Isn't it good? So I chilled out there. The whole campsite was a pleasure to be at. It was riverfront. I initially, when I was planning to leave, when I was packing up my things, I thought of carrying my tent, and then I dropped the plan because the whole idea came to me as pointless. So there's no point taking so much. And there's no point taking so much and then doing nothing with it. Most of my clothes came in as they went, apart from being soaked in fuel. So I stayed there, and food, courtesy, stay, and everything else was amazing at this place. I love this band. The next time I'll be doing Ladakh, or I'll be traveling to this part of the country, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna stay at this vibe. This guy has the same setup. I'll surely stay at this place. If he doesn't for some reason, I'll plan to stay at wherever he has his setup. I slept a bit early because I wanted to make sure I'm fresh enough to take the next day, because the next day was going to be from Jispa to Leh. This includes Baralacha, Tanglangla, Nakila, and the other pass, Lachalungla, on the route. So it was quite amazing. The next day started quite early. He suggested me the last night that I should start early. So after chatting around till 10, I slept off. And the sun turns up. Oh my god! Oh, oh wow. I started around 6. For the terrain, it's too early. Because 6 is like, it's almost dusk. So it's almost dawn, I'm sorry. It's almost dawn at that point. I started at 6. And around the moment I started from Jispa, around 10-20 kilometers away, there is this checkpost. You have to get yourself documented over there that you are passing the checkpost, regardless whether you're a private vehicle or a commercial vehicle. So I went to the checkpost, and the police guy over there, the official over there, asked me the first question. He asked me, your name. I said, my name is this. Pillen. I said, I have no pillen, I have luggage. He said, sir, kisi ko saath le aate. And that's very irritating sometimes. Because I know it's for the kind of people they are and they care about my safety. But man, I want to travel solo. What's the problem with that? So while I was getting that done, there's this chaiwala right in front of this checkpost. I asked the guy to make a black tea for me because I wanted some energy. And I really love the way he motivated me for the coming up right, because I needed that motivation, I think. So he said, जल्दी नहीं जाना है, you don't have to go fast, but कहीं रास्ते में रुकना नहीं है, you don't have to stay in midway, आज ही ले पहुंचना है, you have to reach Leh today. You just know what kind of person you are and what kind of problems you might face. So he simply pushed me genuinely, and I loved the way this guy, and I said thanks a lot man, I'll try to make sure I'm safe. As safe as possible and as quick as possible. So I started off. Dumbass. So I started off and I learned some things about the buses. I would say I learned these things when I was crossing Jalori, because a pass is a point from 5 kilometers or 10 kilometers from the pass before and 10 kilometers after the pass. For sure you will not be getting any roads at all, because they are not feasible over there. Most of the buses get snow in winters, and that's why they are not doable, or they are not feasible to get roads built on them, because the next year or the next season you will have to build them again. That's sort of one reason. And the second is the weather is intermittent at a pass. It's loose gravel. It's completely loose gravel. Uncle ji, takkal aama. तक्का लावा, थोड़ा जा आगे करो, पेट्रोल पंप, कोई नहीं अंकल जी, ये तो गैस वाला है, ये गैस वाला अंकल जी, अच्छा अगले वाला है ठीक है, कोई नहीं अंकल जी। सो एंड अ कपल ऑफ पासेस आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई फेल्ट नकीला वॉज सॉर्ट ऑफ दैट, एंड आई फेल्ट बारालाचा वॉज मोर लाइक इट. So it was not that that uncomfortable, but it was, because it's barren landscape. Baralachala is literally barren landscape, and you will probably see a couple of graves as well. So stones lying in the shape of a gravestone or a tomb. But the place is beautiful at the same time, because it's on the route to Ladakh. So